in this morning. Jehovah Lord, thank you, Father, because of each and every person who is here. Thank you because of each and every family that is represented here. May your touch, may your light, and may your power abide in them fully and in totality. Oh, Jehovah Lord, I know that you are blessing your people and you are touching your people in totality. Oh, Jehovah Lord, there is nothing that is too tough and too hard that you can't do. Oh, we call upon your name, Jehovah Lord, in this place. May you be glorified and may you be glorified indeed. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you want your fire, your power to move with us. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you want your favor to move with us. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, you are great, you are awesome. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are
great. Let us start. That you can't do. We want to see your light. Lord, we want you. We want to feel you. And we want to see you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, speak to us, Jehovah Lord. May this word be a healing into your people. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we need all that sobriety and harmony amidst us. Oh, Jehovah Lord, I know that with man it's impossible, but with you, all things are possible. I know the powers of darkness, the forces of the enemy, all the plots and ploys of the evil one, are ruined, toppled, and destroyed, not by our own might or strength, but by the power of the Holy Ghost. Oh, dear Lord, you are great, you are awesome. I worship you, I adore you, because you are worthy to be praised. And in the mighty name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, may you be seated. Yeah, today I want to preach about spiced up name. Spicing your name. Yes, spicing your name. Let me put it that way. Spicing your name. Yes, for one to be great, your name must be spiced up. Yes, in spirituality, if you access spiritualism by names, we call it onomancy. We generalize it by this name, onomancy. Onomancy means divination by names. And that's why in the name of Jesus we drive demons. In the name of Jesus we are healed. That is onomancy. The Bible says that if my people could humble and call upon my name, I will come and heal them, and I'll send a word and heal their name, their land. That means in the name there is power in names that you are called. There is power in that name that your parents, your relatives, your uncles, maybe your pastor gave you. There is that power behind the name that you have given your child, your son, your daughter, or that sibling of yours. There is power in this name. Why? Because it, name is defined as character and authority. Maybe you are given a name by someone. You are inheriting someone's life, and that person's life was crooked. Maybe crookedness have been eyeing you to devour and destroy your life because of the name you are given by someone. A time has come that out of that name, out of the name that you are given or you are given by your parents, out of the nicknames that you are given by your friends and your peers, it's supposed to be spiced up so that it may smell a good aroma before the nostril, upon the nostril of the Lord for you to be blessed. And the Bible says somewhere in the book of Genesis that people were too evil in that era, in the era of Noah. We call it antediluvian era. Yes, people were too savage. There was something like an anarchy in that era. Why? Because the sons of God came into this world and became children of the daughters of the sons of men. And they got giants, Nephilim, and these beings brought evil into the world. There was too much chaos. There were too much disasters. And people didn't used to call upon the name of the Lord. But it reached a point that there was this young boy who was born, and his parent, Lamech, called his name Noah. Literally, Noah means rest. Rest. But it is saying that after that son was given that name Noah, his parent, his father Lamech, said the very day, the very moment he gave his son that name, he said that this boy, this child of mine, this son of mine is the one who will help his brothers. So that name Noah, which means rest, was added some spices for it to be powerful. The Bible says, the story continues, as Noah grew older and older, yes, he reached a point, maybe it was in his teen, he decided to be an alcoholic. Yes, Noah became an alcoholic. Yes. After some course, we are told that he cast his son out of alcoholism. But I'm telling you, alcoholism could not bar his anointing. Alcoholism could not bar the spiced up of his name, Noah, to be a minister or a person to save his brothers. Yes, sometimes your characters cannot bar you to prosper in life as far as your name is spiced up. You know, rest means kopumzika in Swahili, yeah? Someone who likes relaxing. Yeah, that is Noah. Most of Noahs like relaxing, isn't it? Because their names means rest. But out of that name, his father added up, spiced it up, and said that he is the one who will save his brothers. And out of that spice, it changed his name from just relaxing, from just an ordinary man, to the one who helped his brothers by building an ark from God's command, so that he helped the world generation from perishing in the great deluge during the great floods of Noah. Why? Because his name was spiced up. Amen. God has a spirit, son. Yeah, that name that you own holds a spirit. And there is a spirit that is attached to your name. Maybe your name after your father, maybe your name after your aunt, maybe your name after a prominent politician or a prominent business person. That name has a spirit attached unto it. Yes, and when that spirit is attached unto it, you are most likely to encounter the calamities that strike the person you are named after. So how do you spice up your name? How do you change your name from being a cursed to a blessed person? Yes, you need to spice it up. Yes, you need to add something, you need to add some flavor in that name that you are given for you to live a stress-free life. Yes, people are suffering because of the sins of their fathers. Why? Because they were given the names that hold curses, grudges, hatred, alcoholism, adultery, and all forms of evil. And they don't know. That's why you are passing through calamities. And the Bible says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. In the book of Isaiah chapter 4 verse 6. Yes, you perish for lack of knowledge. Amen. Yes, someone said that. Don't like inheriting things from your parents too much. Why? Because when you inherit things from your parents, you are inheriting the spirits that your parents used to get these things. You don't know what process your parents went through for him to gain or to own the things that he owns. Yes, in TV, to be honest, there is a day that a certain billionaire died and his sons decided to fight on his properties. And he said that they buried, they started dying one by one, because they didn't know where their father got their wealth from. And they didn't know the spirit that works behind the properties they are fighting for. So they end up dying and dying and dying and dying. I think you saw that in TV. Why? Because sometimes we do things by sight and not by faith. Yes, we just maneuver to get things by what we think is right, but by not what we think is right before the eyes of God. The Bible says in the book of Proverbs that let us not be wise in our own eyes, but let us be wise in the eyes of the Lord. Why? Because in this life, there is nothing you can do to prosper. There is nothing you can do to gain favor and peace of life apart from the powers of Jesus Christ to come in your life so that he may give you peace and honor. Peace and honor, joy and happiness come from God. They don't come from man-made things or man-made possessions that we see with our naked eyes. Yes, a time has come that someone has to change and transform his ways of living and believing so that the Lord in heaven may come and pass through your life for him to rectify all the crooked ways that are working behind your life to ruin you in totality. What does it do, sir?
Amen.
Yes. You have to spice up your name for you to be at peace and at ease. And maybe your friends have been calling you poor. Maybe your parents, maybe your teachers, maybe your peers have been giving you names because of the physical things that are attacking you as at that time in your modus operandi. Yes, and these things have attached themselves unto you. Why? Because one has spirits. So when someone calls you a negative name, when someone describes you negatively, yes, that thing forms a spirit and is most likely to attach itself unto your life. Yeah, that means there are some demonic attachments that are hovering in your life to ruin you in totality. And for you to come out of this, you have to spice up your name. Genesis chapter 7. Shall your name anymore be called Abraham, but your name shall be Abraham, for a father of many nations have I made you. Let us jump. Exodus, at the same book, Genesis 17, the 15th verse. And God said to Abraham, as for Sarai, your wife, you shall not call her name Sarai, but Sarah shall her name be. And I will bless her and give you a son also of her Yeah, I will bless her. And she shall be a mother of nations. Kings of people shall be of her. Thank you, Father, because of your word. What does it do, son? Yeah, the Bible says that Abraham was called by God. Yes, and he was told to go to the land that the Lord will show him. Yes, Abraham, as Abraham was going, yes, his name was haunting him. Yes, he was going as who? As a barren man, as a childless billionaire. Yes, as a childless son, as a man without fruits. Yes, as a man that is full of isolation and boredom. As a man that is full of mistiming and disaster. Yes, he was called. Yes, many people here are called by the name of the Son of God. But their life are still on status quo. And their life are still the same. Years in, years out. You are still the same person. This is what happened to Abraham and Sarai. They were going, yes, they were called. But they were living in that ministry, that calling, as a childless couple. And the Bible says, as they were going, as they were moving, things were the same in their life. Why? Because the name that these guys were given, yes, were attached by demonic attachments to ruin and defile their progress in life. And maybe you are here and you are saved. Maybe before you got saved, there are some people who used to attach negative things in your names. We call it onomancy, divination by names. Maybe people used to call you fake names. Maybe people used to tell you that you belong to pervasiveness. The churches to go to belongs to satanism. The pastors that are attending you are cons and quacks. These names were being attached unto you. And from then, things have been marked timing in your life. You have never seen any breakthrough in your life because some people have been talking very negatively about your salvation. Some people have been talking negatively about your faith, about your church, about your fasting, about your discipline and mannerism. And these things have attached themselves into your name and have identified your name, have defined your name for you not to receive anything from the prayers you make, from the fasting and givings you make. Yes, a time has come that you have to spice up your name. The Bible says that from Abraham to Abraham, it is the same name. It sounds the same, but there are some spices that have been added at the top of Abraham to Abraham. When I see you, son. Yes, what the Lord did in heaven, he didn't change his name from Abraham to Peter. He didn't change his name from Abraham to Jacob. He didn't change his name from Abraham to any name, but he added spices in the same name. And the Bible, some people says, now that my mom was a witch, and I was named after my mom who was a witch, what will I do to come out of this curse? No, you don't need to change that name because it's a process. It is a process to change that name. If you follow the legal process according to the laws of the land, it is a very long process to change the name, your original name in your certificate and your national identity card. What you have to do out of that name, you have to add spices unto it. Then, I was telling some people that out of great men, there is greatness. What does it feel, son? Yeah, there are some names that are attached to poverty. Maybe Abraham and Sarai was attached to barrenness, was attached to fruitlessness. That's why they were barren. But the Lord in heaven saw them and came unto them and told them, from today, I'm adding spices into your names. Yes, I'm adding spices into these names that you are called. Yes, from Sarai to Sarah. Is from Abraham to Abraham, and from these names that I'm adding spices unto. After that, the Lord used to tell them, after adding these spices to their names, the Lord told them that, I will make a covenant with you, I will bless you. There is no way you can be blessed if your name is not added spices unto it. Yes, if your name is just the name that people used to call you, yes, people used to mock you, people used to laugh you, and you are a believer, no matter how many times you fast, no matter how many times you pray, you will still maintain and will still be the same person now and then. Hey, that's why today I'm telling us today that you have to add spices in your names. Hey, they used to call you that you're a loser. They used to call you that you're a failure. And for years and years and years, you look like a loser. You look like a failure. Time has come that you have to come up and add spices in the names that you are given by your parents, by the names you are given by the nicknames you are given by your peers, in your school, in your college, or in your home at the village. You have to add spices to this name. You have to tell God, God, now I'm adding spices to my name. Now that I'm Tony, I'm not the ordinary Tony that people used to know me. I'm not the ordinary Tony that people used to mock me and people used to laugh and scoff at me. Now I'm a blessed Tony. Because the Bible says somewhere, let the poor say that I'm rich. Yes, I'm adding that spice of richness in my life. Yes, the Bible says that I'm not the thief, but the dead. So I'm adding that spice of headness in my name so that wherever I go, I'll be the top and not the tail always. I know that wherever I go, I'm blessed, and even the blessed will call me blessed. Yes, this is adding spices in your name. A time has come that you have to add spices in the name that you have given and call yourself blessed, call yourself a prosperous person, call yourself a king, and give yourself names that regards to nobility. Amen.
Amen.
Then sometimes we remember, he used to call me poor. He used to call me a crooked daughter. Yes, my father used to curse me now and then. My mother used to call me a prostitute. But after being called those names, what have you done to get rid of such? Words are powerful. Yes. What has you, son? What has you? Am I talking to someone today?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Someone is sleeping. And you say that when the congregation is sleeping, you have to tell the preacher to wake up. What has you?
Amen.
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 Am I talking to someone today? You know, sometimes we say that we don't care how they call us. And most Christians nowadays are called poor and confused by the people of the world. Yes, and they go to church every Sunday. They fast, they pray, but that confusion seems not to run away from them. Because after being called confused, yes, they embrace it and tell themselves that even Christ was called something, so I don't care. What does it feel, sir?
Amen.
Yes, they compromise. You know, sir, you perish because you lack knowledge. And that's why the people of the world are prospering more and more than us. And because they insult us, and we just keep quiet saying that, they don't say that you have to apply the turning to other chief philosophy. I'm telling you, when someone calls you poor, and you embrace that poverty in yourself, no matter how many times you pray and fast, there is no way that poverty can run away from you. You have to do something upon that word that enemy have called you out. What are you supposed to do? You have to tell God, no, I'm not poor. I know that I'm rich. Yes, he called me a poor man. There is a friend of mine who called me poor while I was in class 3. There was a fellow student who called me a failure. Yes, and I've been failing in life. But now I'm reversing that. How many times have you taken to scrutinize your life and to try to bring up the negative words that people have ever spoken to your life? How many times have you ever prayed for your name? How many times have you ever cancelled the negative names that people have been calling you in your life? And we just pray, God, help me, I want to get rid of poverty. But how many times have you ever cancelled the negative words that people have been calling you? Maybe your parents, your teacher, your friends, your relatives, your enemies, or anybody. How many times have you cancelled these things? Yes, out of this mess that people have been calling you up. Yes, they define your current life as you are living. That's why you are not prospering. It's not because you are bewitched. It's not because you are accursed. But it's because you assume. Ignorance has no defense. Yes, you have to cancel these words. You have to cancel these negative words that people have been calling you about. And that's why even Christ bore that. And there was a point that Christ sat with his disciples and asked them, what does people say I am? Yes, he is Jesus, isn't he? Come on, he is Jesus when money is in use. And yes, Jesus said, who gave us the turning to other cheek philosophy? And the one who presented that philosophy in the Bible.
He was bothered by asking his disciples, what do you think people say?
But Peter stood and said, you are the Son of Man, you are the Son of God, you are the Messiah. And out of that positivity, positivity from Peter, what is Christ saying to Peter? Peter, Barjona, it's not you who have said so, but the Spirit of the Most High have revealed that unto me. Why? It is the Spirit of God who spiced up the negative names, that people used to call Christ before. So Christ was sanctifying his name. Yes, Christ was purifying his name out of that through the help of the Holy Spirit that used Peter to sanctify his name. Well, think about it. What has it been, sir? Yes, even Christ sanctified his name. Well, how? Through the power of the Holy Ghost. Yes, a man of God can sanctify your name through the power of the Holy. Remember, it's not by might nor strength, but by the power of the Holy Spirit that we are healed, that we are redeemed, that we are sustained, that we are retained. It's not by your strength. It's not by your reasoning. It's not by going to school and passing exams. It's by the power of the Holy Ghost that our names are transformed, washed, and cleansed for us to abide in God's glory and abundance in life. Yes, people have been calling you conmates. And you're a believer. You have to rebuke that name mercilessly. You are not a con. You are a blessed one of God. And people have been calling you a debtor. Someone who lives in debt. You have to cancel that and tell yourself, I'm no longer a debtor anymore. People have been calling you the reject one. People have been calling you that nothing can a man or a woman desire from you. That's why you're not married. You have to cancel that mercilessly and tell yourself that I know that I'll be accepted. I know that God is going to give me peace and solace in life. I'm going to enjoy his ecstasy wherever I go because I'm blessed. I was telling some people here yesterday that the greatest weapon that the devil uses in his arsenal is poverty. Why? Because where there is poverty, there is confusion. Where there is poverty, there is no love. Where there is poverty, there is sickness. Where there is poverty, there is stress, suppression, and depression. That is the greatest weapon the devil uses. And this is the greatest weapon the devil has been using against the church. And how has the devil used this against the church? It's by the people of the world calling the people of who are called by the name of Christ poor. Are you getting saved? You say you're poor man. Are you a pastor? You say you're poor man. Do you want to minister? Oh no, you say you're poor man. So why? Because we have embraced that. We have read that by saying, it's true. Even Christ was called poor. He was impoverished for us to be rich. Yes, Christ was impoverished for us to be rich. He was not impoverished for us to be poor. That's what the Bible says. What does it mean? So why do you embrace these negative things? The Bible says that we are blessed. The Bible says that those who accepted him give them power to be called the children of God. And if you're a child of God, you are the king. If you're the child of God, his kingdom will come into your life. His kingdom means his abundance, his peace, his health, his connection, his wealth, his health, his ease will be upon you. But why is it that these things are not coming upon you? It's because we embrace negative names. We take all the names, all the garbage, all the trash that people are throwing against us. We take them and we embrace them. We say that it's just okay. No, it's not okay until you rebuke them and sanctify your name and tell yourself that I know that my back is not haunted anymore. My past life is not haunted by any negative name that people used to call me. Maybe your teacher used to come into the classroom, a mathematics teacher, and curses all the students in that class and say you will be failures and fools. Because you don't want to do mathematics, because you don't do homeworks. When they curse the students in class, these curses, I'm telling you, hurt the students. That's why you can go to school, you can pursue your education and your curriculum up to the university level, but you're still a poor man. Why? Because someone somewhere defined your name and you embraced it and has been haunting you for years and years. Remember, in salvation, it's just easy. It's just confessing the name of Jesus Christ and you get saved. That's how powerful your name is. If you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, you are saved. If you confess the name of Jesus Christ, demons flee. If you confess the name of Jesus Christ, poverty, confusion, chaos, sickness flee. What about if someone confesses a negative name in your life? Yes, it affects you. It destroys you. There is power in names. That's why names are defined as characters and authority. So it doesn't matter who ever nicknamed you. Doesn't matter what your parents used to call you when you make a mistake. Those days you used to live with them. If you are willing and ready to sanctify your name by the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There is no way your blessing can be attached into your life without sanctifying your names. And there is no way you can live a life, a stress-free life, if you fail to sanctify your name. Yes, maybe it is a drunkard. Maybe it is someone who used to smoke weed that nicknamed you in your teen years. Yes, maybe they used to say that you are a useless fella. Maybe they used to call you a loser. Maybe they used to call you a zombie. Maybe they used to call you a dweeb. A dweeb means a very silly person, one has a favorite, because of salvation. And now that you are saved, you still see the traces of stupidity and zombiness in your life. You still see the traces of negativity, of delay, procrastination in your life. It's because of these people that used to give you names. There's a time has come that you have to call upon the name of God to sanctify your name. And that's why even before Christ was born, Elijah prophesied almost 1,800 years earlier that this man will come and his name will be called Emmanuel, the Lord with us. That means there is very much, it is very important to call someone a good name. It is very, very much important in someone's life because it will affect the rest of your life, no matter how old you are. That's why King Solomon said somewhere in the book of Proverbs that a good name is better than gold and silver. Yes, it's not a matter of gold and silver. It's a matter of your name. Why? Because if you are called by your good name, gold and silver will follow it. Yeah, that's why Christ said somewhere that seek the kingdom of God first. You have to be called by the name of the kingdom of God. You are a righteous man. You don't have any blemishes. You are the son of the Most High. Yeah? That's what it means. Be called by the kingdom of God first. I'm a Christian. I'm a righteous man. I'm blessed. Because that is the kingdom. These are the things that are found in the kingdom of God. Well, after being called by the name of God, after being called by the name of the kingdom of God, gold and silver will follow you. Yeah, that verse continues by saying, and all shall be forwarded unto you. Yes, your material things, your husband, your wife, your children, yes, your possessions, your recession, your everything, the things that the Lord promised you even before the foundations of this earth were made, will just follow you without struggle, without a sweat. Why? Because you are called by the name of the Most High. And because when people see you, they see Christ in you. And that's what happened to Peter. The Bible says that the day he was denying Christ, and someone looked at him and said, this man was with this man who is crucified. And Peter denied and said, no, I was not with this man. Yes, as he was speaking, another one came and said, hey, even the way he's speaking, he's just speaking like this man. He said, no, I don't know this man. He decided to walk away. As he was walking, he looked unto him and said, even the way he's walking like this man. Why? Because his name was attached to that man. Who is that man? Jesus Christ. Yes, if your name is attached into Jesus Christ, if your characters are attached to Jesus Christ, you'll never hide. People will just be seeing you and saying, truly he's been called a blessed person. And when he speaks such things, when he confesses such things, he's sanctifying your name. Out of those three confessions of that person, who was accusing Peter of knowing this man led to Peter's redemption later in life. We find out that even after denying Christ three times, out of these three prescriptions that were given in that verse, yes, Peter was forgiven. But Judas hanged himself. And these are the two people that made the greatest sin and mistake in the Bible, Judas and Peter. So Peter perished because he didn't get someone to purify his name from a traitor to a blessing. So he perished. That is Judas. But Peter, out of that wicked man, that man was not saved really. Maybe he was a gentleman, maybe he was a Pharisee. But out of the words that he spoke, they gave life, restoration, and order into Peter's ministry. That's why the Bible says in the book of Psalms, chapter 1, that blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked. And don't make someone joke with your name. Don't entertain jokes when it comes to your name. Because in spiritualism, there is no jokes. That's why I normally tell people that I don't like comedies. You can never see me watching church in life. What does it feel, sir? And why? Because they mock people. And they say that, hey, this person is like this, and people laugh. Those are scoffers and scorners. And when they do things, when they say something, these things become real and active to people's life. And where are the lazy comedies? Look at the jokes that they present to people. You will find out that these jokes, they affect these people in their lives, and these people behave just like the jobs that people used to call upon them. That's why it is a point that when these teenagers mocked Elisha, he cursed them. He called upon them, the what?
The bears.
The bears from the bush to come and consume them all. Why? Because they mocked Elisha. They looked at him and laughed at him and said, look at that short, bad guy. Elisha cursed them instantly. Why? Because he understood the power behind those mockeries from these youths. That's why I want to tell people, in Christianity, there is no jokes. And sometimes, you have to be tough and radical. Because the Bible says that the violent shall take it by force. Sometimes you have to be violent. When it comes to your life, when it comes to prosperity, when it comes to your success, when it comes to your deliverance, you have to be radical. But when someone told you you are poor, yeah, so what? Somebody need a poor. Hey, when someone told you that you are a curse, so what? So what? When you embrace some things, I'm telling you, they will haunt you. When someone calls your child a fool, the Bible says that there is a place Christ saying somewhere in the book of Matthew that whoever does what, whoever calls his brother a fool, he is in danger to the fire of hell. You're just calling your brother a fool. That means that foolishness will come upon you. Yes, I was being somewhere and I told people how foolishness comes into people through a demon called what? Who remembers? Through a demon called Pazuzu, yeah? So if you call someone a fool, hey, he may be entangled and possessed with this demon. Is it true? If you call someone in Jesus, if you tell someone in Jesus' name, you will be blessed. Out of Christ's blessing, this blessing will be attached to that person. Because I was reading the story of this man, the richest man in Africa, called Aliko Dangote. I used to think that this man is a mystery. But that man said that, he said in an interview, I was reading that article, that people confuses me as a mystery. But I'm not a mystery. I'm a Christian. I'm a Baptist. But Christianity. So he said that as the days that he was a teen, he suffered a lot. Yes, he used to walk barefooted. He came from a very poor family and used to attend a church, a Baptist church in the village, in the woods. So there was a day that he was in that church, he attended that church barefooted. And a man of God was preaching in the pulpit and looked at him. Yes, he looked at that teenager and that man was pitied. Because of that man's appearance at that time. So he called him and he started blessing him. And he told him, from today, I'm releasing the blessings of Jacob in your life. I'm releasing the powers of prosperity in your life. Oh, he prayed unto him and he confessed blessings and he cancelled all the negative insults that their neighbors used to insult them. Because they are very poor. You know, if you are poor, you would have had all the calamities and disasters. The Bible said that it was on a Sunday that that man was blessed like that. So, the following day on a Monday, he went into a bank and he was given a loan. Hey, you wondered, how can a bank give me a loan and I don't have a guarantor? So long after he was loaned your quarter, he started businesses. He started businesses, one business after the other. And I'm telling you now, that man is a millionaire. He's the richest man in Africa. He has almost $45 billion in his account. Why? Because someone somewhere added spices in his name. And that man became blessed instantaneously. So that man used to say that he believed in Jesus Christ. And he said that there is power in Jesus Christ. He said that there is power in Christianity. There is power in the church. And there is power in confession. He said that the man of God confessed blessing in his life. And now he's the richest man in Africa. So you need someone to confess blessings in your life. You need someone to breathe blessings in your name. Yes, you need someone to breathe blessings in your future. You need someone to breathe blessings, yes, in every area of your life for you to be at ease and at peace. Yes, remember the story of Abraham and Sarai? They were called from the land of the Chaldeans. Yes, many people used to give them names. Many people used to tell them that they don't have kids. Maybe people used to call them, they are barren, they will die childless. Yes, as they were going into the promised land, the land that the Lord promised to show them. Yes, as they were in that journey going, yes, these curses were still attached unto them, and they were still barren, and they were still the same, despite being talking and communicating to God. Yes, beside you coming to church, praying, fasting, and giving, yes, there are some curses that are still attached unto you. But the Bible says, it reached a point that the Lord was coming to visit them and saw that they are still the same. And they are still childless. And the Lord was monitoring in the spiritual world and the spiritual realm. Why? Because this is Jehovah Adonai, the divine master. So he was monitoring their divine destiny and discovered that some people used to speak and throw insults into this couple's life. Yes. Yeah, the Lord was monitoring them. And the Lord was monitoring them. The Lord said, now I want to do something remarkable in their lives. I need to turn the table and present the a feast before their enemies. So what am I going to do about it? How will that work? Yes, I have to use all the divine system of protocol and order for I to bless these people. So the Lord descended from heaven and told Abraham, now I want to change your name. I want to add spices in your name. I want to give you a decent name from my mouth. I just use the same name that you have to sanctify the same name that you have. So to receive the same blessing that I promised you. And now, from now, you are no longer Abraham, but Abraham, the father of many nations. And out of you, I will make a great nation. And all the generation of this earth will be blessed through you. Now these blessings, and these promises, and these covenants came after the Lord spicing up Abraham's name. Yes, for Sarah to conceive, for Sarah to be promised to be a mother of king and queens. Yes, her name, Sarai, was added some spices into it for Sarah to be given power to conceive in her old age. Spices were added into her name. I'm telling you, the Lord that we serve is not limited. Yeah, don't say that you are too old to be blessed. Don't say that you are too young to be blessed. Don't say that you are too 50-50 to be blessed. What matters is your name spiced up by divine system of order and protocol. Yes, if it is spiced up, I'm telling you, you have all the legal rights to prosper. You have all the legal power and mandate to be turned from grass to grace. To be turned from glory to glory. Why? Because the power of God is moving in your life. Because the power of sanctity, the power of favor, the power of breakthrough is moving in your life. And that's why the Bible says there was this young man whose name was Jabez. Jabez was a man of God. He used to worship God in truth and in spirit. Yes, he used to be the most honorable man in his family because of his mannerism and discipline. But because his name was attached into suffering. Jabez means sufferings and pain. And the Bible said that as he was being born, his mother said that because this child came out of sufferings and torment, I will call his name Jabez. Jabez means pain. Jabez means suffering. So anywhere Jabez used to go, people used to look at him and say, oh, that poor man. Anytime people used to see Jabez, they used to say, that man is hungry, he don't have money. Anytime people used to see Jabez, they used to give him old clothes, second-hand things, because they thought that that's the life this man belonged. Because this thing haunted him for years and years. Yes, he was a believer. Yes, he used to pray God, he used to worship God, he used to discipline himself according to Christianity and all the laws that are in the Bible. But he never ran out of poverty, suffering, and torment because his name was tainted. And the Bible says, it reached a point, that is the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 9. The Bible says that it reached a point that Jabez called upon the name of the Lord and said, oh Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, may you send your hand into my life and may your face shine upon me so that I may not cause pain anymore. Yes, what is pain? Pain is Jabez. And he was talking about his name. Yes, my name is painful. My name means suffering. Yes, I'm characterized by suffering, by isolation, by rejection. Yes, people are not understanding me. People are not understanding my character. They call me an outcast. They call me the most cursed person in my family. Now, God, may your face shine upon me and may your hand move with me, so that I may not cause pain anymore. And the Bible says that, and the Lord in heaven listened unto Jabez's prayer and heard him, and said, now Jabez, from today you have hit the bullseye in your spiritual battles. Yeah, it's not a matter of demons in your life, it's not a matter of magic in your life, but it was a matter of prognosticators, it was a matter of scoffers, scorners, it was a matter of jokers in your life. Now I've changed your name. The Bible says that the Lord listened into Jabez's prayer and opened his life and rewarded him mightily. And that's the turning point. That was the turning point of Jabez's life. Remember, the Lord didn't ask Jabez, go to school and read. The Lord didn't ask Jabez, go and see that person and he'll give you a job. God didn't tell Jabez that go and I'll give you that land. No, he just blessed him. And his hand moved with Jabez. And the Lord of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob expanded him. Why? Because Jabez dealt with his name. Tell me, what name are you called by your brothers? By your sisters? By your brothers, in your family, yes, by your parents. Yes, you have been praying, you have been giving your tithes, you have been fasting. But tell me now, yes, how did they used to call you before? By your neighbors, by your exes, maybe, those days that you are not saved. Yes, tell me, what names did they used to call you? And look at your life as at this time. Are these names haunting you? Yes, are you being haunted by these names as at that time? Yeah, they used to call you that used to be the churches you go to are being led or ministered by fake and false prophets. Yeah, look at your life. Have you been entangled by false ministers of the world? Yes. If it is yes, that means these words are affecting you. Yeah, someone used to call you poor. That's yourself. Are you rich? Do you ration food in your hands? Yeah, that's the first sign of poverty. What are you doing? Amen. There are no facts and facts. Yes, are you rationing food in your house? It's because someone called you poor. So you may live in a 5-bedroom house, but no food inside. Because there is someone who called you poor in your teen. Maybe you're 5 years old, and someone looked at you and said you are poor. No? That thing is haunting you. Up to date, because spirits never die. Yes, have you been encountering negativities in your life now and then? Yes, did your parent die cursing you, telling you that you never succeed in life, cursing your marriage? And that's why there is no order in your family. And that's why there is no way you can tie with your husband in totality. And because someone cursed your future. Yes, someone has been speaking negative and ill against your life. Yes, a time has come that someone has to arise and call upon the name of the Lord to sanctify your name. Yes, you are not the one. You are not supposed to live the life that you are living under the child of the Most High. Yes, you are not supposed to be barren in your finances, in your womb, yes, in your relationships, yes, in your maneuver, in your spiritual growth, the way you are, and yet you know the true God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. There is something somewhere that is happening and working behind the curtains to pull you down, to ruin you, and that's why you are ruined. Why are you magtiming in poverty, in confusion, and in sickness now and then? Yes, and you have been praying, and you have been casting the powers of darkness, and the demons and ghouls in hell have been fleeing from you all along. But your life is still magtiming. Your life still has no signs of change and transformation. You are still the same person who used to be even before you got saved. And the Bible says that if you get saved, you will be blessed according to the book of Deuteronomy, as from chapter 28, yeah? This blessing shall be accompanied by you. Yeah, the Bible says that the book of prosperity, the verse of prosperity, the book of Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, it says that if you abide in the word of the Lord, you will be blessed in all the areas of your life. Yeah? That's what the Bible says. That's why the Bible and Christianity is a fraternity of success and prosperity. But how comes that you are still magtiming? How comes that your siblings, your relatives, your friends are still mocking you, and they have those legal rights to mock you and call you names? It is because and judge you as a poor and a failure person. It's because of the names that they used to call you, and you embrace these names. Yeah, you are comfortable with these names. Yes, it's hard to. Even your younger brother, your younger sister, he is calling you a poor man, giving you a name, and you're just embracing it and saying it's okay. No, when you embrace these names, you are embracing poverty and chaos. The Bible says, after Peter confessed that Jesus Christ is the Son of the Most High God, what did Christ say? Christ locked out all the other names that those people said and stood up and blessed Peter and said, out of that, Peter, you will be the rock of the church. Out of that, because you have done something in my life, yes, I'm the Son of God, but there's some things I can't do in totality because I'm 100% God and 100% human being. I needed someone and the Spirit of God to talk to someone to sanctify my life. So out of that sanctity, Peter, yes, I'm promoting you. In you, I'll build my foundation of my church. In you, Peter, I'm investing all my resources in you. And in you, Peter, I'm telling you that before you die, you reap 100 times fold because you have done something remarkable in my life. A time has come that the man of God has to speak favor in your name. A time has come, yeah, that you have to despise your name and start calling yourself blessed. If you are poor, call yourself rich. Yes, if you are weak, call yourself strong. That's what the Bible says. If you think that you are a cursed, start calling yourself the blessed, the most blessed person ever. That's why I normally tell people, stop hanging around with people who are not worthy in your life, because they will pull you down and down and down. And there is no way you can come out from that downness to the top. Yeah, let me repeat this verse. Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the way of sinners, nor sit in the congregation of scoffers, but as I do, that's what the Bible says. Don't make someone make jokes, make fun of you. No. You have to rebuke such people the way Elisha did and tell them, no, don't call me that. If you don't know my name, please don't call me such a thing. Don't call me Mama Boga. What else if you? There's also some people are called Mama Boga, and after someone like, you Mama Boga, that way, give Mama say that one for Mama Boga, Mama Boga. I can tell you, Mama Boga, Mama Boga. No, tell people that I'm not Mama Boga. Call myself, this is my name, I'm called Tony. So you have to call me Tony. If you don't know my name, please, I've told you, don't call me Mama Boga. I know that I'm not here for my lifetime. I'm just here for a season. Yes, I'm just here for a testimony. I'm writing my testimony. But soon I'm moving out of this place. Yes, don't call me a ghetto girl, nor a ghetto boy. I'm just here to get a testimony. Because very soon, I'm on my way to Karen Lorunda. Because that's where I belong. Amen.
Amen.
God has a few.
Amen.
That's how dangerous jokes are. Amen.
Amen.
There is no joke in life. Life has no joke. And life knows no joke. Yes, if you allow someone to mock you, then you say that I'm saved. Eh? What did you about? And that person will mock you and will prosper. But we have another one, the same person. You will be going to that person to beg him, help me. And that person will be treating you as he wants. And there is a saying in my mother tongue that says, he who feeds you can rebuke your mom in your presence. Is it true? Yeah, because this person is a wicked man. This person is a crooked man, he's a drunkard. But because he feeds you, yes, he can come and abuse you the way he wants. He can call you any name that he wants. You have to tell such people, out of my house. If you think that you'll come to my house to demean me, if you think that you'll come into my house to mock me, or to laugh unto me, or if you think that you're a boss into my life, I'm taking you out of my house. You don't belong here. Sometimes you have to be a king in your life. Don't welcome any trash in your mind. And some people are supposed to be locked out in your life completely for you to prosper. Yes, some lords, they're called lords, like in a Judas Iscariot, are supposed to be permanently deleted from your life for you to be liberated. Yes, you have to sit and hang around with people who will speak positive things in your life. And people who will bless you, people who will respect you. But if you see and spot any trace of despise, I'm telling you, you need to cut off that communication permanently and move on with your life. Because he's not your destiny helper. He's not the one who created you to take care of you, but your God. Tell yourself, now I'm not hanging around with this person. I better have one friend in my lifestyle who will be blessing me now and then than have 30 million friends who will be mocking me, laughing me, and judging me negatively because of what I have or what I'm passing through. So I better choose one friend and move with him. But no, out of this one friend, God will give me another one. God will provide another good friend that I have so that they will help me grow spiritually. They will be speaking positively unto me. And out of this positivity, I'll be elevated. But if you hang around with crooked people, yes, you are trying to be like them. You are trying to dress like them. You are trying to eat like them. You are trying to present yourself like them so that they may love you. Yeah? So that you may take everything, so that they may rebuke you, they may mock you, they may trash you, they may trample you, because you just want to hang around them. You are misplaced as a believer. You have to know that you have the Most High God who called you into the ministry. He's the one who will take care of you. So no matter what comes your way, you have to stand with your God. And if there is anyone who is trying to stand between me and my God, kick him out. Because he will contaminate you. If you walk with a crooked person, expect crookedness. But with the same feathers, flocks together. Show me your friends, and I will tell you who you are. These are natural laws of nature. Amen.
Amen.
You know, someone was telling me, I live in this county, but in this county, I don't have any friend in this county. Yes. My friends are from far. Yeah? Because people here are just senior zombies. So there is no way I can relate with these people. Some are accusing me. They are saying that the day I'll be struggling with calamity, who will help me? But I don't care. I know that my help will come from God. Yes, I better walk alone with my wife and my children than walking with a bunch of failures. Those who will insult me. Those who will pull me down by their negativity. Don't fear to be alone sometimes in life. Sometimes it's good to walk alone. You better walk alone for a season. Yes, even if you walk alone, you'll just walk alone for a season. God will just connect you with people who will come around you because no one is an island. Yeah? God will just connect you with right people in your life. So you better walk alone for a season. You know, people fear breaking from some friendship because they are benefiting from them. Yeah? Comrade friends, we are talking about friends last Sunday, yeah? Because they are benefiting from them, yeah? They are like, it is like parasitism. I'm hanging around this person because he can give me 200 bob. Yeah? No matter how negative he is, he will give me 500. So I have to humble. No! If you happen to such people that are humbling before demons and the devil, you have to knock them out and tell God, connect me to someone who is real. Yeah? So walk alone for a season. Walk alone for a season. Then walk with masses who will demean you, who will demoralize you, who will make you unprosperous in your life for a lifetime. For all the years that you have been living with those friends, tell me, what have you achieved in life? Nothing. What has it been? I was telling some people, one of the greatest scrutiny or scale of knowing if the people you hang around with are a blessing to your life or a curse is, you have to ask yourself, from the day I met my brother Basit, what have I achieved in life? Yes, you make an hour of 50 for almost 5 years. What have I achieved? If there is nothing you have achieved from that person, keep that person out. It's radical, but it's a fact. Amen. Amen. And there is someone who used to work at the Kedar Airways. He was very rich. He was not very rich. But he used to have a very good salary. He was big, a salary I can get at 95,000 plus. That's a good salary, isn't it? But because that person was nurtured in a certain slum, you see that I've been nurtured here. I've been playing football here. Yes, what I'm telling here, that my friends. So there is no way I can shift from this place. So that man came to me, he said, you want to buy a car? And you're living in an iron sheet house. You are a fool. Because it can never happen. That car will reject you. You have to change your living status. He said that, yes, I want to change, but there is no exit I can go to. Because I was natural in this area, so I have to live in this area because of my friends. So I told that person, change. He didn't listen. So he bought a car. Do you know where that person lives nowadays? And that person I took a car. Akaanza kuuza bangi, akashikwa na bangi. Akapelekwa jela. Watoto wake wakakuwa chokorazi in these slums. Maisha itakuwa ngumu. Mke wake akaanza kuuza changa.
Amen.
And that person now sijui kama alitoka. I don't know his whereabouts now. But sasa. But the last time I heard about him, that's what happened. Why? Because he hung around in a crooked environment because of crooked friends that he had, yet he was saved, and out of that confusion, there was a great fiasco. Are you hanging around confused people? Are you hanging around a confused environment? And are you not willing to live such kind of lifestyle? If you are not, please do. Yes, I was telling people that even shifting from point A to point B is not easy. And because you kick a man, you can't move. You can't move. You can't move. What happened to Abraham will happen unto you. He went with his father, but he was called to go alone. He said, I can't leave my father backwards. Hey, let us go with my father. Yes, I have to please my friend Lot. Let me go with my Lot, my relatives, my kinsmen. The Bible says that before Abraham was blessed, these people were supposed to die. They died. Abraham's father died, Terah died, and Lot died. Yes, after they died, Abraham received blessings and abundance, exceedingly abundantly. So these people that Abraham used to hang around with, they were a symbol of delay and Abraham's blessings. Sometimes you may delay your blessings because of the environment and the friends that you're hanging around with. Yes, because you are too much into your friends than God. You are too much into your friends than the blessing that the Lord has given you. Yes, there are some blessings that before you receive them, you have to shift. You have to change your lifestyle, both emotionally, physically, and spiritually. Yes, I'm changing my mindset. I'm changing my life. Why? Because I think that I need to receive some blessings in life. For I to receive these blessings, I have to change my friends. I have to change the way I see things. I have to change my mindset. I want to change. Yeah, you have to change for the Lord to change you. But if you hang around with people who will defy you, if you hang around with a prostitute, Yes, people will be calling you a prostitute also. If you hang around with a drunkard, yes, that attachment, that drunkenness, yes, will be attached unto you. If you hang around with a failure, with a rude man, yes, if you hang around with a prostitute, yes, he, she or he is most likely to attach and define your name. Because when people see you with them, they will say, we are the only one, isn't it? People will start saying such things. So these things will never run out from you. And because people will define you as they look you. So a time has come that you have to walk alone. The time has come that you have to decide to live a boring life for a season. That poison your life with negative people for a lifetime. Yes, we pray for people, we fast for people, but still they are the same. They are not getting the so-called jobs. They're not getting prosperity because of the attachments they have, and they don't want to cut them off. The Bible says that you have to apply the chop it off philosophy. If it is your hand that is standing between you and your blessing, chop it off. If it is your eyes, you have to pluck it off. If it is your foot, your leg, take it off for you to be liberated. Amen.
Amen.
But if you attach yourself unto it, you will go with it into hell. And there is no remedy for that. Remember the book of Proverbs chapter 29, verse 1. It says that he who is severely warned, but not rebuked, and hardened his neck, it shall break him without remedy. So many people, many Christians are breaking without remedy because of the things they have holding on. A time has come that you have to spice up your name. And for you to spice up your name, you have to walk alone. You have to sit down and monitor yourself. And ask yourself, is it that because I'm attached to some people that I'm the way I am? Is it because these people that I'm attached to are giving me names that are making me my time and being the same now and then? So from today I'm chanting my calls. Over the keys and the nation, let us start.
Take it in.
negative name. If there is anyone calling you a failure, a loser, if there is any friend of God, if there is any pastor, if there is any person, if there is any parent, if there is any witch, if there is any teacher, that calling your failure a loser, or a neighbor's drama, that you have to change your name. If there is any comedian who have called you names, who have mocked you, let us call upon the name of the Lord. The Bible says that whoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How comes that people are calling you negative names? How comes that you have tried to?
Oh, dear Lord, may you help us, Father. May you help us, dear Lord.
They have been called fools. They have been called rejects. Oh, today, I'm adding spices into their names. I'm adding blessings in their names. Wherever they go, they'll be blessed. Wherever your people go, will be blessed. I'm prophesying jobs to the jobless. I'm prophesying money. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are great. You are awesome. I'm speaking against cancer. I'm speaking against ulcers. Oh, the people, the doctors have been saying they will die with diabetes. They will die with cancer. They will die with ulcers. Now I'm reversing that. I'm reversing it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For there is no name that you are given. He's the earth beneath or in the heaven above that is greater than the name of Jesus Christ. Their parents have been calling them losers. Their parents have been telling them they are regretting why they begot them. Oh, today I reverse these things. I'm calling them blessed. I'm calling them blessed. I'm calling them blessed. I'm calling them blessed. Yes, I can see that curses are lifted. I can see that there is power. I can see that there is the spirit of God is moving. Yes, it's moving. It's moving. Yes. Yes, it's moving in form of a certain warmth. Yes, a certain warmth. And a certain cold. Yes, warmth and coldness is bursting in your life. This is a symbol of breakthrough. Oh, the Lord is telling me that some people's lives are going to be transformed and reformed. Oh, for their betterment, of their future. Oh, Jehovah Lord, you are great, you are awesome. I glorify your holy name. May you kneel down. Kneel down. This is a symbol of bowing down before the Lord. Oh, lepa nese bele forose. Ale bara patoso bolo balanse bele. Ale bere patoso bolo fe. Ale bara palo se le bele forose. Oh, in the mighty name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. I anoint this water, Jehovah Lord, as I sprinkle into your people. As I sprinkle them into your people, may it be a symbol of sanctity. The Bible says that Jesus Christ was baptized by water, and when he was baptized, the open heaven of the heavens opened. Oh, Jehovah Lord, may I use this water, Jehovah Lord, as a symbol of opening their heavens. I know that the miracle is not in this water, but in your spirit, Jehovah Lord. This is just a symbol that I'm using, but the Spirit of God will open your people's heavens. I lock out the spirit of suffering. No more suffering. No more singleness. No more ulcers. No more cancer. No more failure. No more disaster. No more brokenness. No more poverty. No more failure. No more losers. No more poverty. No more poverty. No more poverty. No more poverty. No more death. No more singleness. No more singleness. Oh, le palese belete. Ale bara paloso borote rehese bele forose. Ale bara palase torohose bele forose. Ale bara palose beles. Oh, the Lord has visited this place in a mighty way. I can see the yokes broken. I can see the chains broken. I can see the fetters opened. I can see those who are in the John coming out of these chains. Oh, le palese bele torohoso. Those who have been experiencing rejection. Those who have been experiencing insults and mockeries. The spirit of lies and deceptions are being lifted from your people, not by my own might nor strength, but by the power of the Holy Ghost. Oh, Jehovah Lord, may this water be used as a symbol of purity and purity in your people's life, in the mighty name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Yes, may you receive it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May you receive it in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May you receive it in Jesus' name. May you receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name. Receive it in Jesus' name. May you receive your blessings. May you receive your spices. From today, Jehovah Lord, your people are transformed. From today, Jehovah Lord, your people are opened. From today, Jehovah Lord, No more curses in your people. No more lack in your people. No more poverty in your people. No more singleness in your people. No more rejection in your people. No more despise in your people. No more negativity in your people. No more negative friends in your people. May you arise. May you arise. Ale farase beleto rohoso bolopatese. Ale farase beleto rohoterese. Oh dear Lord, you are great, you are awesome. I love you, I adore you. I glorify your holy name. I magnify your holy name in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now I want to bless your hands. Yes, I want to cast down the powers of poverty in your hands. In your hands. In your hands. All those who have been saying that you'll die a poor man. Those who cast your hands. The people that used to bless, and instead of blessing you, they used to throw curses in your life. Today they will be ruined. Their words are not coming to pass in your life. Yes, those hands that are doing businesses, the business hands, those who are applying for interviews, or those who are working but they don't get anything out of their works, or they are working from hands, their money, Jehovah Lord, is transformed from hands to baby. Yeah, they are working for their belly and legs. They don't know even where their children's school fees will come from. They don't, today, Jehovah Lord, you are sending man. I can see the heavens opened. Yes, I can see the clouds, the white clouds in the heavens. Yes, I can see the angels, a platoon of angels, witnessing this today. Ole patese bele forose bele holose bele te. Ale barapo lose bele pantase bele holosa balakase bele ro. Ale balalo te bele toro hose bele forose bele te. Oh dear Lord, you are great, you are awesome. I love you, I adore you, I magnify your holy name. Ale barasoto rohose bele forose. Balo parase bele forosa balatese. Ale barapatoso bolo parase bele holose bele horumanase. Oh, dear Lord, you are great. Yes, lift your hands now. And in the mighty name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Oh, Jehovah Lord, I do hereby anoint these hands. I release your anointing in these hands. I release your anointing in these hands. I release your anointing in these hands. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Ole pateso bolo farase bele holo barate. Ale pelose beleto rohoso bolo parate rehese. Ale barapalose beletoso bolo farase belente. Ale beresolo bolo telese. Ale farase beleto rohose. Yes, I can see deaths in these hands. Oh, I can see deaths in these hands. Oh, Jehovah Lord, no deaths. No deaths, Jehovah Lord. No deaths in these hands. Oh, may you quicken these hands so that they may get money to pay their bills at the right time. From today, Jehovah Lord, these hands that are lifted, these hands that are lifted, they will not borrow, but they will lend, Jehovah Lord. In Jesus' name, may you receive it. May you receive it. May you receive it. May you receive it. From today, Jehovah Lord, anything that this hand will touch will be turned into gold and silver. May you receive it. May you receive it. May you receive it. Oh, lefelese beleto rohoso. Oh, if there is any curse that is haunting this hand, there is any curse of poverty and failure that is haunting this hand. Yes, I can see that there is some people here who are bewitched by their teachers. And there is a lady here who was bewitched by her teacher because of composition. He wrote a very wonderful composition. That teacher took it and cursed it because of envy. That curse is lifted in Jesus' name. Amen. Yes, I can see that people here have been given ultimatums that they will never prosper. They will live in status quo. Yes, they will be impoverished and even reach a point that they will not be in a position to pay their bills and rents in totality. That curse is lifted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Oh, Jehovah Lord, the curses of hanging around with bad people, bad company, wrong friends is lifted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Ale baraso bolota rahase bele polosa balapatiso bolopetese bele koromanas. Ole farase bele to.
Yes, curses from former pastors, former men of God, who curses your people without a cause. Jehovah Lord, that curses is lifted in Jesus' name.
Amen.
peso bonuta la se belefi la barasol al bese balo bereso bolote ne hes eo jopa no despido fecha I V8 oh despido fecha I V8 and all the STIs is being lifted now in Jesus name. Oh, your people are freed. Oh, your people are freed in totality. Your people are freed. Your ministry is freed. Oh, your power, Jehovah Lord, is upon your people. Yes, Jehovah Lord, the hand of operation. I can see some people surrounded by neurosurgeons for operation. Oh, this curse of operation. No one here will go under the cut. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, the curses of operation, the curses of operation, I release them into your people's life now so that they may not haunt them. I release these curses that are binding your people so that they may go to Sheol. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and now I release the power of the Holy Ghost to prevail in your people, Jehovah Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, your people are freed. Your people are freed indeed. Oh, the powers of living in shacks, the powers of living in slums. Oh, Jehovah Lord, your people are not going to spend their lifetime in slums and shacks. Oh, if this curse is following your people, oh, they are loose now. They are loose in Jesus' name. Oh, Jehovah Lord, your people are free. Your people are freed, Jehovah Lord. No more delay. Jehovah Lord, if they are being delayed, they are blessed because of the friends, the negative friends that have attached themselves unto. Oh, may you bring confusion. May you bring confusion to those friends that they may not visit them again. That they may not come closer to them again. A time has come that you have to choose them good friends. Friends that are worthy. Now I open their heavens. I'm opening your heavens. Your marital heaven. Your financial heaven. Your job, your health, your relationship, oh, your spiritual growth, your talents, your gifts, even in this ministry, I open these heavens, oh, I release funds, I release blessings in your education, in your career, in your profession. And now, Ale Patese Bele Foroso Bolo Teresi. And now may the Lord keep you.
Amen.
And may the Lord sustain you.
Amen.
And may the Lord empower you.
Amen.
And may the Lord move with you.
Amen.
And may the favor of God shine upon you.
Amen.
And may the power of God be with you.
Amen.
And may the favor of God be with you.
Amen.
May the power of God move with you.
Amen.
And may you receive it.
Amen.
I can see that some people are free. Let's see what we are for. Light. Yes. Yes. Who is light? If you feel that your body is at ease, may you clap your hands. Don't drop your hands if you are not feeling anything, yeah? I want those who feel like they have received something. Yes. May they clap their hands. Yes, if you have received, or if you know that there is something that has happened, or may you clap your hands. Yes, today the Spirit of God has taken control. Yes, I can see some things happening in the spiritual realm. Yes, I can see the fetters being loosed. Yes, I can see that people used to be called failures from time immemorial. I can see some people's parents used to regret why they begot some people here. I can see that you are younger siblings are attacking you, are mocking you and laughing and giving you ultimatums, and they have just cast you as nothing, as nothing but a persona non grata. Yes, but the Lord is preparing a table. The Lord is preparing a table. Yes, I'm telling you, the Lord is giving you ideas. The Lord will connect you with people who will catapult you to another level. Yes, I can see that the Lord is moving into people's health. I can see the power of God is, oh, the Lord is great. Thank you, Father, because of your word today. Oh, your word today, Jehovah Lord, has healed your people. Oh, le palose beletoro hoso boloparate, boloparase beletoro hose beletoro hose. May you be seated. You just go and sit. Everyone, just sit down. Ale palose beletoro hose beletoro, ale barasoto lo hose beletoro hose beletarase, ale berepolose beleto, ale barapalose. I can see that the Lord is going to connect you with the people who used to despise you.
And those people we used to mock you. Some people receive calls. Some people receive calls from friends. Long-time friends. Friends that they forgot about in life. A long, long time ago. They will call you and try to monitor how you are doing. Yes, how your life is doing. And I can see that the Lord is connecting you with ideas. Ideas that will catapult you to such levels of greatness. I can see that people are being blessed materially and physically. Oh, it was just because of this sin that has been haunting our lives that we didn't knew it was haunting us. But today, I'm seeing the power of God. I'm seeing the favor of God. And I'm seeing the light of God working in our lives in totality. I can see that there are some people here who have been looking for jobs, who have been applying for jobs, but in vain. But I can see the heavens are being opened, and the Lord is giving you the jobs that you applied for many years. I can see the Lord is doing something remarkable in your lives. And I can see the power of God, the hand of God moving and working in totality and in reality. I can see that delays are being lifted. The spirits of procrastinations are being lifted. I can see that there are some friends who will just avoid you because the power of God is separating them from you. They are the curses barely to your suffering. They are the curses barely to your mock timing. But the Lord is destroying such friendship by the power of the Lord. Remember, the battle is not yours, but God. Don't fight these things by your own might nor strength, but let the Lord fight for you. Let the Lord defend you. Ole bara paloko rosa balande rehese dele forosate lehese ali bara palose direito roboso bolo falase delete. Oh, Jehovah Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, I'm just directed to sing this song. Oh, sinibite mo. Praise and worship.
Oh, sinibite.
Yeah.
Isaac and Jacob. I release Abrahamic blessings in your life.
Yes.
I release Jacob's blessing in your life.
Yes.
I release Joseph's blessings in your life.
Yes.
I release sevenfold Abrahamic blessings in your life.
Yes.
Ole palo sebeleto rohos balatere hasebelefi. Ole balapalo sebeleto so bolo palasebeleo rohose belekantasebeleo. Oh, Jehovah, thank you, Father, because your people are receiving peace.
Amen.
They are receiving peace.
Amen.
They will receive peace.
Amen.
They will receive peace.
Amen.
I seal in the mighty name of Jehovah Emmanuel. May you receive peace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jehovah Shalom. May you receive peace.
Amen.
Receive.
Amen.
Receive.
Amen.
May you clap for the Lord.